Good morning to one and all. A warm welcome to second day of 5-day international workshop come FDP on discovering your PhD potential, writing a research proposal, jointly organized by Internal Quality Assurance Cell, Northeastern Hill University, Shillong, Meghalaya, and the Indian Society for Training and Development, ISTD, Shillong chapter, in collaboration with the Department of Philosophy, IQAC, Moran College, affiliated to Dibrugarh University, Moran Heart Charai District, Assam, and Department of Philosophy, Sri Venkateswara University. Special thanks to our Honorable Vice Chancellor, Professor Prabhasankar Sukla sir, for allowing to organize a series of programs for the development of students, scholars, teachers, and researchers, and academia. Professor Deekshit sir, Director IQAC, Professor Mipun sir, ISTD Chairperson, Shillong Chapter, Professor Mithali Kovama, Principal Moran College, Dr. Rajendra Prasad Bhartakur sir, Coordinator IQAC Moran College, Dr. Srutasini Gogoi Madam, Head Department of Philosophy Moran College, and Professor Chinnaya sir, another coordinator, and my own guru, and noble participants. Actually, I waited some of participants, they texted me, sir, we will join at 7:40 like that. Okay. But this is one of the good practice. Because of this one only, even myself, I changed my lifestyle, going bed early and work up early. Without further delay, I'm going to share. Now I will divide this up. I will take the presentation almost 30 minutes. One of the participants, Professor Dr. Raja Ghosh from West Bengal, suggested, sir, please present your presentation slowly, 20%, like that. Really, I'm happy. We are always ready to accept whatever suggestion, good suggestions given by the participants. I will move on review of literature, ICT integrated review of literature. Then after that, we will go for hands-on activities. Those who join through laptop or desktop with good internet, please be ready to share your screen. You can complete week one of MOOC courses, identification of a problem and review of literature together. With this, I'm sharing screen. And before that, we will start our program with Vande Mataram. That is always very important to show our respect toward this great nation. What is happening in Ukraine, Russia, Sri Lanka, you know. Thank you. Right. So ICT integrated review of literature, here innovative approaches, how you can do review of literature. There are 14 types of review of literature. I think I can stop the fan. Right. So the objective of this paper, today's session, actually this one I prepared for an international conference, to motivate the scholars for effective utilization of ICT tools for review of literature, related literature, to familiarize the list of reference tools in educational research. When I was taking class at a PhD coursework, many research scholars, they are started to type in the MS Office their references. I asked, do you know about reference tools? They said, no, sir. So they never tried how to use the reference tools, and in the reference menu of MS Office also, the citations and references, bibliography. The main difference between the references and bibliography, whatever reviews or research evidences you cited in your research, it is must to refer in the references, and something you are referring but not using directly for your research, but you felt it is very useful for your research, then it is better to give under bibliography. So reference is an integral part of bibliography. If you take Venn diagram, suppose the Nehru Maula area is a part of Shillong. Shillong is bibliography and Maula is reference. So it is our duty to always, some interviews they ask what is difference between objectives and references and appendices in general, whatever tools you are using in for your research for data collection, primary data or secondary data or whatever extra information, you can keep all those things under appendices. Appendix is singular, appendices is plural. Data is plural, datum is a singular. Hypothesis is a singular, hypothesis plural, right? So it is our duty always start our day. Whenever I woke up, I always start my day with the Suprabhatam of MS Subbalakshmi of Lord Venkateshwara. If you wish to plan for a year, show seeds. If you wish to plan for 10 years, plant a tree. And if you wish to plan for lifetime, develop a man. Here, Ching Chu, 7th century BC. So whatever you are doing always in education, micro teaching, macro teaching, we are always doing plan, teach, feedback, replan, reteach, refeedback. Here, defining the objective of the review, defining the approach for the review, and developing a coding scheme. Actually, this coding scheme you can use for qualitative research. And the selection, developing keywords. How in the presentation I'm going to show you, those who joined the first time, 7S model of learning and teaching. Myself and Dr. Swathasini Gogoi ma'am invented this, such select, study, skillful, store, share, and smarter. Every presentation I'm always keeping for the awareness of the scholars. Whenever you are searching, you are always using the keyword. Whenever you use the keyword, it is better to put a double inverted quotation or PDF after keywords, DOC or PPT, and or not, question mark and asterisk and functions. These things are very, very important. And the database searches, even ICSS or abstract databases are there. And UK Core database, CORE Core, and we have a Shodh Ganga 3, EPG Pathashala, National Digital Library, N number of Diksha portal for school education, N number of databases are there. Defining dominant themes and analysis, coding of journal articles and thematic analysis, and under Friday programs, we are always organizing under research and publication. Your coding journal, how to read journal articles, we can do later. Now we started the qualitative research methods and results, thematic results and descriptive results. This is very important, structuring your literature review, how you can structure. See how nicely this one, background more to do with your topic. Yesterday we topic, title, problem, and research questions. Just a reverse pyramid in the same way. Here, distantly related to your work. Area than your, I think it is locked. I can stop it. Participant, please try to be here. Sometimes you are going and coming, going and coming. I can unlock, just 1 minute. Yes, now I unlocked the meeting. Because of some technical issues, I can. Koti, I'm in class. I'm in class after 9. Right. Right. So this one here, narrow categories, you may deal with the sources in more detail. Dr. Raja Ghosh yesterday asked what is the narrow down of your problem. I just given the example of Meghalaya and Shillong. Categorize here close to your research and you may find you are looking at a few key papers in detail, your study current research issues. Suppose COVID-19 pandemic, impact of COVID-19 pandemic on achievement of the students. Here, when you are telling students where, maybe whether it is North India or South India or Northeast states within, suppose I can take again Meghalaya, within Meghalaya, whether it is rural or urban, within students, maybe primary students or secondary students or higher education students or teacher education student teachers, who it is better to narrow it down. Within a slow, I just asked my student teachers to collect data during COVID pandemic. Many rural-based schools, they don't have even smartphones. The teachers are also network issues, unable, really very sad during those days. Now, before coming to the class, I read article regarding Shanghai city of China. Almost 2.6 crores of people now, their situation is very pathetic because of COVID-19 pandemic and lockdown of the whole, almost 20 cities in China. It is. Now, if you see impact, other than these 20 cities is different, in 20 cities are different. Even Jackie Chan, you can see the movies are also Shanghai city. So here, what I want to say, whenever you are going to do review of literature, it is better to identify your title, topic, research problem, and research questions based on research questions and categorize and chronological. Some of researchers, they ask, sir, how to do. It is better you can select, suppose I can take one example, digital empowerment, learning styles, and academic achievement of the students. One of my scholars, Ruby Tamang, she selected. So I asked her to categorize EAPC, digital empowerment, learning styles, and academic achievement. Within digital empowerment, you can select chronologically, or newest to oldest, or oldest to newest, and alphabetical. It is better to follow in all the themes in the same method. One way you are selecting A to Z, in other way you are selecting Z to A, and newest to oldest, and oldest to, you know, it is not good. The systematic, that's why research itself is a systematic approach, better to do like that. So here, see how nicely they are mentioning. Define your research question. Yesterday already, inclusions and exclusions. Something you can include, something you can exclude. Identify relevant search terms. Here, scoping search terms in related literature. And develop your search plans. Already I mentioned about and or not even this apply truncation and wildcards. The question mark and asterisk I can show you. Test and refine your search. Check results for key articles, apply limits or filters. And even good advanced search, Google Advanced Search is also very important, because whatever available in the internet is not copyright free. It is your duty. Sometimes there may be a chance you can face a copyright issue. Some of teachers, they lost their job because of copyright issue. One vice chancellor, they already I mentioned, lost her vice chancellorship because of copyright issue. Select relevant databases and run searches. Document and manage search results, save search and EndNote. RefMe, RefSeq, EndNote, Jotero, all the search reference tools, even you can use for filtering the reviews. Organize your literature review. How to organize? What is the purpose of your literature review before? That's why yesterday I told why to attend this program. Maybe one is an enhancement of your skills, knowledge, or for a certification purpose, for promotion and other things, whatever it is. But we have some purpose. To provide an overview of the big issues, select some of these issues for your future research. To summarize other people's work, because what is happening, if you know, then you can. So whenever I am attending as a resource person for MOOC related issues, I always go to FutureLearn and other MOOC providers. Swayam 2.0 now we are using. At Swayam 1.0, the course organizers provided more than 1 hour, 2 hours videos. We are not watching any movie to watch such a long videos. It is better. The video, effective video must be 5 minutes, 15 minutes maximum. Otherwise, it is better to divide. Otherwise, it never, because human minds never concentrate more than even 5 minutes also. The maximum period is 45 minutes. That's why I said I can present within 45 minutes and we can do hands-on activities. To fulfill the norms of UGC only, we are keeping 1.5 hour and 1.5 hour self-directed learning. To provide here, to evaluate others' people's work already, to provide context for your future research. To identify gaps in the existing literature, that's why whenever you are writing a research proposal, after review of literature, one subtitle, it is your duty to mention research gap. What the research gap identified? Suppose someone COVID-19 pandemic, they done so many students achievement, but what about the students of special students, those who are not able to see, those who are not able to listen, those who are not able to walk? Is there any study they done? If they are not, because for general students itself is not a is a problem to attend online classes, what about these students? Whether some students, maybe their parents are illiterate, they're supposed to at lockdown at home, no one at a family to help, how they can continue their studies? This is challenging issues. We can do this type of research. That's why the Deeksha put some direct to home DTH channels. There is no need of any internet, only power and a TV. If there is no TV also, what about? So someone is a digital divide. Even Nandan Nilekani, the co-founder of Infosys, expressed the pandemic extended the digital divide more. To develop an understanding of the theory or method, here the qualitative method always. After thorough study of many digital information and doing many courses, I came to know there is a system we to study through online. That's why the 7S. First step search, then it is your duty to select what to select, why to select, when to select, whom to select, how to select. Then study, study also skimming and scanning. In the next slides, I can show you. Your literature review has 5 objectives. Everything is objective learning outcome. Motivate your work by explaining its social value. Provide background context for your readers. Compare your findings with research, with other research. Justify your experimental method. Communicate your projects, your scientific novelty by framing a research gap. Here, I am just recalling the days of Sri Venkata my days at Sri Venkateswara University. I entered Sri Venkateswara University in the year 2004, August 2nd, and I left at the 24th, April 2013. Still, I remember dates and everything here. Srilata Kishori Madam and Jagadishwari Madam and many others from Sri Venkateswara University, they are regularly joining. I participated every year, 21st September International Peace Day and 10th October, December International Human Rights Day. I received so many essay writing, elocution and a quiz of prizes, Professor Krishna S.R. Law Department. Why I'm telling all these things? Whenever I read any essay or writing any essay, I start with introduction and end with the conclusion and underlining main points and dividing, keeping content in the bullets and our numbers. Within a limited space, I can provide more information. That's why always I got prizes. In the same way, it is our duty to review of literature also. No need to give n number of pages. You can take exactly what it is. You are taking, suppose from any banana you are taking, you are not taking everything. So you are just taking inside. In the same way, it is our duty, whenever you are reviewing what to take, when to take, how much to take, it is very important. Then literature review for introduction and versus discussion. For introduction purpose, use previous review literature to introduce your research. Suppose COVID-19 pandemic, someone did on students. Now to teach for the students, we need a teacher. So how to train for teachers to train the students, it is better in that way. Discuss subject-specific literature after the general introduction. So identify knowledge gap, always research gap, knowledge gap based on previous literature. And here discussion, use previous studies. Whenever you are, this one we can use in analysis, data analysis and interpretation. So at that time you can use what are the findings of other research, what research may be supporting your findings and what research may be opposing. So it is your duty. Only include references that are directly relevant to the topic target audience. So certain things, it is not good to mention unrelevant information to increase the pages. Do not cite review article unless essential. See, so empirical, it is very important. So literature review, introduction, how many chapters, how many pages or paragraphs you can keep. Some of researchers, they mentioned introduction, you can keep 1 to 2 paragraphs. Please remember, whenever you are doing review of literature for papers or even a thesis, context, importance, aims and intentions, scope and key themes. For body, key theme expanded, highlights importance, draw conclusion, expert views, theories, include all materials. In the conclusion, again, 1 to 2 paragraphs. Outline current knowledge, identify areas, not it. So see, I mentioned about introduction and conclusion. It is must, not only here, even whenever you are PG students are also joined here. Sujana from Gautam University and others, for PG students and scholars, it is your duty to some of research scholars from Nagarjuna University, your duty to write your answer with started with the introduction and end with the conclusion. This is very important. Outline the current knowledge and identify area not yet addressed. Again, see what type of this is very important. Question the literature review could ask questions a literature review could answer. So what were the aims and objectives? Here, what is this subject important? What approaches, schools of thought, theories, methods, and strategies were used? Here, what overall theme, method, and theories were used? In what context were the research publications conducted? How do publication relate to other research fields? If you see the SAGE publications, Springer Nature, Tyler and Francis, and the other international reputed publications, their approach is extraordinary. What were the outcomes of the publications? What are the gaps in research? That's why I always research gap. If there is no gap, no need to do any research. But if there are advances in the COVID-19 pandemic, everything, whatever research tool you used earlier, those tools are not exactly suitable to use during the pandemic. Now the situation is changing. What is each publication's contribution to the field? Why there is a need of publication? Publication, the three main purposes, one, number one, transmission of knowledge, preservation of knowledge, and creation of knowledge. This is, but at the same time, again, constructivistic approach, they, no one is giving knowledge, no one is taking knowledge. It is your duty, you are constructing your own knowledge based on your previous knowledge and past experience. But it is our duty to think 360 degrees. Here, who has done something similar to what I will be doing in my research? Sometimes the same. When I was thinking about the, before approaching any station, it is better to announce, just like in buses, in the train also. But when I visited New Delhi in the year 2011, while traveling in metro, I realized that someone has the same thought. So that way, many things, what gaps, problems are evident, what can be adapted to my own study, do publication related to my own research, asked, and what will my contribution to in this field? Professor Chennai sir, always motivating me, what is my contribution? As a teacher of Northeastern Hill University for academia, these publications, I'm publishing papers, I'm delivering lectures at other universities and institutions, and I'm organizing by myself. These are all, and creating e-content through YouTube. These are all our contribution. So it is better to show, and the way of approach, I'm always keeping 360 degrees in my mind for beginners to expert. How to start? 1,000-mile journey start with the first step. It is your duty. Please don't always plan and keep it better. Plan and execute. Both the things better to go parallelly. Planning and executing, planning and executing. Otherwise, it is not no use, not good. Take some time to process what you have read before you start writing. It can be helpful to organize notes, sources, important points, and potential quotes into word processor. Tomorrow I can show you how to note taking. There are three ways to take note taking, and such as Microsoft Word, to have everything centrally collected. This enables you to look for keywords. That's why whenever you are writing any article, it is must to keep the keywords. Based on keywords only, your search results will appear, and people can cite your paper based on your citations, your rank, everything will increase. Prompt for the initial writing about the literature. Ask yourself what you already know about the literature. That's why when I started my PhD, my professor B. Ramachandra Reddy sir, my supervisor, mentioned why to use a review of literature in research. What is the purpose? Everything and definition of review of literature very nicely. I learned a lot. Use bullet points and mind maps to cluster ideas. Not good to write too much. That's why word gives single meaning, image gives 1,000 meanings, and video gives million meanings. Better to use mind maps, concept maps. I can show you one of my scholars at the end of this presentation, how she used these mind maps and the chart to understand her research. I got that one through my supervisor. On the basis of these ideas, you may wish to organize your writing using here subheadings, which can help you to create an outline of your literature review. Not only this one, every chapter. Last week, I interacted with my student teachers at B.Ed. level, at M.Ed. level for dissertation purpose. I given the outline of the first chapter. Nicely they done, they came and I suggested for the second chapter. whenever you are preparing any dish also, you need first ingredients. You maybe keep everything, maybe here many mothers are there, and girls, they whenever they are preparing, not only girls, even boys, whenever you are preparing any dish, you keep everything in your mind, what to prepare and how much to prepare and in which way, everything abstract. These subheadings could be based on the above outlined questions. So that's why research questions are very, very important. Structuring your literature review, introduction, main body and conclusion, already I mentioned, I don't want to take more about because I'm going to share this one through my blog after at the end of the program, so you can go through it. Suggestions for your writing style. How you can see, traditionally XY was concerned with at the start of the XY here, century, and with the rise of XY, they're giving just an example XY. So among the more influential writers on the subject are XY. To date, no research within field of XY appears to have the writing of X and Y allow for synthesis of general ideas within the literature on XY. So actually here, on the basis of the literature, it possible to argue that XY is. So here they are giving just one example. If you experience difficulties, contact your lecturer or supervisor or the learning development services for future guidance. Suggestions for writing your style. Actually, whenever before writing your review of literature, it is your duty under your discipline or subject, what type of style they are using, whether APA, American Psychological Association, right now, 7th edition we are following. Within already review of literature, we mentioned whenever you are writing an abstract, abstract is in middle and bold. So this type of Times New Roman and 1.5 space, like everything and how to use. It is 7th edition and MLA and IEEE. So engineering, so medicine different, and social sciences, philosophy, the arts, Cambridge. So many types of citations are there, even styles, it is better to know before writing. So these are the very important, I can show you 14 types of review of literature reference tools. I think some of participants are joining first time, they already texted me. It is better you can go through this site. This is my blog, hamsareddy.blogspot.com, and if you just remember this link, I can paste in the chat box, you can keep. Right, already I posted. The review of literature, this one is UOW, means University of Wollongong, Australia. This one, what I did, I have two things. I can open this one also. It's a new window. And this is my Google Drive. I use 7S model, search, select, study, skillful, store, and share. So here, fourth and fifth step, store and share. SMART is the 7th step here. A typology of reviews, an analysis of 14 review types and associated methodologies. Actually, this one is used, is a review article, and it is in medicine field. Actually, the doctors, they are using different types of review types. Here, different types of reviews you can see. Simply, I can this table, you can make a little bit. So here you can see the critical review, literature review, mapping review, systematic map, meta-analysis, even you know about metadata, mixed studies review or mixed method review, overview, qualitative systematic review, a qualitative evidences synthesis, rapid review, scoping review, state of the art review, systematic review. Systematic review, we are using even research method also. for research, systematic search and review, systematized review, umbrella review. Someone asked when I was presenting what is the umbrella review here. Specifically refers to review compiling evidence from the multiple reviews into one accessible and usable document. Just an example, umbrella, you can see umbrella, how it is connected with the different groups. So focuses on broad condition or problem for which there are competing here interventions and highlights review that address these interventions and their results. Identification of component reviews, but no such for primary studies. Quality assessment of studies within component. Actually, they are mentioning how to when to use and appraisal search method, appraisal and synthesis very nicely. See what type of methods they can use and simply they're mentioning. And how the authors and description, number of studies, based on number of study, because used the systematic review to review this article itself at the beginning, he mentioned is a review article. So based on review only, how many reviews they studied, you can get download by yourself. This is University of Wollongong. While doing MOOC course itself, I got this information. Those who are beginners, you can see what is a literature review. Very nicely, see how nicely they are mentioning. Literature review examine and evaluate the scholarly literature on a topic, any particular topic, whatever. Here, a literature review is conducted in the beginning stages of your research and is written either as a stand-alone document or as a part of larger piece of work, as a chapter in the thesis. So review of literature, not only in the dissertation or thesis, even for your research paper also, it is must. So that's why based after review of literature only, you can identify the research gaps. The purpose of literature review, again, there how nice the Australia. That's why I'm always going through the Australian universities material, e-research, digital capabilities, research capabilities. Provide context of your research hypothesis or question. Ensure your research is original, not already published. Whenever someone is asking for publication, they are always write unpublished. Identify where your research fits into the existing body of literature. Suppose I want to do some coastal on ocean, research on ocean. But in Meghalaya, there is no such type of ocean. We have river, but it is not possible. The available, so it is your duty where you can data is available or not in the geographical, whether the physical form or highlight the strength and weaknesses in any previous relevant research. When I am going through the some research, even satisfaction, the research scholars use the scale of attitude, strongly agree, agree, disagree, undoubted, and strongly disagree, strongly disagree, 5-point Likert scale. But they are measuring the satisfaction, that is almost wrong. So it is their duty, how much, whether the frequency always happy or very much happy or not at all happy, it is better the levels of happiness or frequency of happiness. Almost is wrong. So I can identify the what is the weaknesses, even satisfaction level also, they did the same thing. They used the attitude scale and measuring the satisfaction level, it is wrong. So make recommendations for further research. One of researchers, they used a conflict identification scale, the title of the tool, but a scale is to measure only, not to identify. Through questionnaire or through interview only you can identify. It is not possible to identify through the scale. Scale is always to measure. It shows the level. So a good review, literature review is focused and analytical and critical. See how nicely it's relevant to your research and meets the purposes of literature review as outlined above. It does not need to include everything you have read. That's why whatever you read, if you feel, you can give the bibliography, but whatever you cited, it is best to give in under references. It's focused on ideas and relationship between ideas rather than just the authors. Critical. It makes comparison between different concept theories. your own interpretation and evaluation need to be evident. Very professors sometimes they give their own idea interpretation because of their extraordinary experience and knowledge. So it is better always think out of the box. But sometimes you are always inside the box. See, this time actually the working hours starts 9:30 to 4:30 college hours. But I started without disturbing my college department functions. It is better to organize. That's why I selected this time beyond out of the box. So systematic review. A systematic review is a special type of review that typically takes months or years to complete and can be written by multiple authors. So systematic review, someone want to study, is this a COVID-19 pandemic? So it is not possible to study everything. As a teacher, you can study at a school or college, but what about the home? So it is the parents or any educated people at the locality, they can. So in that way, some of articles, they written more than 7 to even 12 authors are also. Everyone, suppose I'm ICT, someone is a social background, someone is a science background, someone is engineering background, everyone. Just like I can give you a live example, this building. So carpenters, they done their work. Electrician, they done their work. Civil engineer, they done their work. So like that, everyone, they contributed and they done it. After that, we are calling it as building. The same way, research also, you can use multiple researchers and persons help to do. At the same time, never hesitate to take help from the experts. Even sometimes you can pay and use also, but only everything to be ethical. Professors recons are in the Department of Political Science in Northeastern Hill University mentioned, it is better you can sometimes, you can take help of those who are working in the publication wing to publish. It is not bad, you can so suggest it. Fine, here examples of literature review, how to write literature review, simply we can go through this one. How to write literature review. This site is also very important, you can see how nicely, there are n number of material is available. Only thing you need time to go through it nicely to understand how to write literature review. To say frankly, at a university levels also, the experts are not in a position to show you the right direction how to write a literature review. So literature review via learning development, literature review via learning co-op, here writing a literature review PDF, we can see this one, how this is from University of Wollongong website. How university libraries are providing in the foreign country, you can see. But our Indian universities libraries are not up to the mark. Other types of writing literature review here, purpose. Example, so they are giving summary. See how nicely they are started. This is the literature review, is a survey of the literature on your particular subject or area of interest. It involves finding out what literature is available on the subject, what the main area of research are, who the prominent researchers in the field are, and what the current and possible future research questions are. Significantly, a literature review involves a discussion of research database, that is, which researcher agree or disagree with each other and why. So actually in the field nowadays, after nice my way of presentation of ICT related, because of my background science and philosophy and education ICT, almost many HRDCs and universities, they are calling me again and again, and already I got some recognition of ICT teacher like that. So here they know that, oh, this teacher may be familiar with these subjects and he knows many things, and because of doing again and again, in the same way, the reviews, how I got because of reference through our programs, through our lectures, through our publications. In the year 2008, when I was doing my PhD, that time 9 awarded on Kameshwari, her madam, senior almost 60 years, she contacted through mail after reading my online article on moral values. Still, I have contact with her. So this type of, based on your writings, and some teachers, they called, I read your article in the university news. So you will get recognition through your writings. Still, we can remember Vemana in our Telugu literature, Kabir, Tulasi, Rahim in Hindi literature, so many. It is our duty. An example here, literature review experts. They are always started with introduction. You can see how nicely I'm posting this link also with all of you. If possible, what you can do, simply take the 2 pages only, print out and keep, and you can do it by yourself. We need always template with. So see, when designing sensory systems for robot, one good source of inspiration is nature. Animals, big and small, have sensory abilities that enable them to move around in unknown surroundings and respond to different kinds of situations, which is what we ideally want mobile robot to be able to do. If we are able to understand how the animal sensors work, then we should be able to make a model of sensors and adapt them to work with mobile robot. Very nice. You see, that is true. Suppose you can see whether maybe birds are also the opposite sex, how they are attracting. Even some birds, they make noise, so they can sing to attract the opposite gender. In the same way, many during tsunami at a T silent in tsunami, tsunami, Andaman Nicobar Island and Indonesia, maximum number of ethnic groups, tribals and animals, they escaped from the disaster. But those who are civilized people near the coastal area, they are not in a position to escape because they lost their sense. They don't know how to sensory, how to use their sense abilities of the sensory motors to find. Sometimes the farmers, by seeing the clouds, they can understand whether they will get rain or not. No need of any scientific evidence because of their experience. So they can sense. Even Professor Chennai sir, because of his extraordinary yoga meditation, always sense what is going to happen. One problem with mobile robo is how to get them to navigate safely in rough terrain. Here, legged vehicles are more adaptable than here wheeled ones. But then there is a problem of coordinating the movement of the legs. You can see the different types of animals. By seeing birds itself, Wright brothers, they invented an aeroplane. So in the same way, many things, even you can gravitational pulse, Archimedes, many things, Newton's, Madame Curie, radiation. So she received a Nobel Prize in both physics and chemistry because of observation skills. That's why see as it is and see innovatively, see differently, see creatively, see again and again. That is why research, search again and again. If whenever sometimes you have an example, your mom asked in the kitchen or somewhere storeroom, you identify something, but you are not able to identify because of you are not able to focus nicely. But when your mom or father approached, they identified within minutes because they are familiar, they concentrate. So it shows. See how nicely headings divide information into sections, orientation to topic, outlines a whole review. Here, previews topics to be covered. Actually, the previous and the tactile sensing, order sensing, how nicely, and the aim of review, overview of new sections, approaches and key researchers, background of information at the last and the conclusion. See how nicely second approach, description of research objectives, and summarize the whole review of current research. That's, see, in the beginning we read introduction and other things, maybe one or two paragraphs. Here they're simply given three paragraphs of introduction and last summarize with only one paragraph. How nice. This is a published by Learning Development, University of Wollongong. See, other types of literature review. So it is your duty, whenever you are visiting any website, always better you can go through like this. Again, you can see how search effectively. From here, I learned many things already. I did identify search words, tips, and connect your search words and are not. Already I told about these things. I'm going to show you. There are n number of improve your search results by using these tips and EndNote, Jyoti Rossi, literature review search title, Excel sheet. Just I can show you this one, what they mentioned. Actually, we can organize one FDP on review of literature itself. Without review of literature, nothing. Identification of everything, it starts with the review of literature. Taking some time. Yes. See how nicely they're given. How to use search tracker, search, even search result summary, Scopus, Web of Science, discipline database. Oops. See how nicely they are doing. Even a scholarly, a Google Scholar, if you give your references of the discipline, automatically it will send published articles, review articles to you automatically. So this type of things, you can go through it. This is about, so another thing, citing and referencing, this is also very important. Jotiro and me and all these things I got. This one also I published in the year 2018 in my blog. I'm posting this one in the chat box. You can keep this information also. We shared this one during our 10-day FDP also. Right. So see, already all the material I already kept in my blog. That's why we can teach more things within a limited time. Best example to understand this one, if you are going to your home after your class, if you are preparing by yourself your food, it takes time. But if you visit the same hotel, maybe by paying money, you can get service. In the same way, always better to manage your data. So here you can see, online tools for references, Mendeley, Jotiro, Digo, EndNote, RefMe, Plagiarism. What are the, this one is very important to watch this video. Actually, when you did maybe good work, you will be appreciated. If you did any wrong things, you will be punished. So this video really wonderful about, actually this is a Spanish, but subtitles in English. Can just pause for 1 minute.
Bare levere den.
Vent!
snarion i mig och bli trött i kroppen. I tillägg kan examen bli annullert och du riskerar att bli kastet ut av universitetet.
Okej, okay. Jag skjønner poenget, men det är ju inte alla som blir tatt.
Ikke si det. UiB har faktiskt ett hemmeligt vapen.
Med UiB sitt elektroniska EFORUS-program som sätter alla inledare ska du faktiskt vara ganska heldig för att komma undan med juks. Så du måste ställa sig ett spørsmål.
Do I feel lucky? Well, do you book?
Sector 47
is
getting out of control.
Oh, har du noen tenkt på hvor langt du kan gå hvis du skriver en god oppgave uten å jukse?
How do we stop this thing?
There is only one man who can save us now. We need the world's leading expert on artificial intelligence.
I suggest we create a GUI interface in Visual Basic.
You hear that? Do it! Do it now!
Det du oppnår ved å gjøre det riktig, er nemlig unik kunnskap og kompetanse innenfor ditt arbeid.
GUI interface in Visual Basic.
Ja, dette ser litt ut ut. Men jeg vet ikke hvordan gjør det riktig. Det finnes et fantastisk sted. Der du finner det du trenger av informasjonen.
Honest research, what type of benefits you will get. So I provided extra material here, you can go through it. Right. So this one, I did a courses and review of literature. You can take the clicks and research writing, how to do a literature review, University of Wollongong. Through this course only, I got all this material. And one more course also I did on a systematic literature review and introduction, Coventry University. So these two courses really benefited a lot. Select a topic, search the literature and write the review, survey the literature, critique the literature, develop your arguments. These are the literature review process, 6 steps. Here again, it is interconnected. You can see here introduction, topic 1, subtopic 2, topic 3, topic 4, and conclusion. Always start with introduction and interconnected with the themes and sub-themes and conclusion. What is the purpose of literature review here? Find out what information already exists in your field of research, then identify gaps. This always is the most important objective of review of literature. Find other people working in your field. Suppose I have a few, always whenever I'm delivering lecture at HRDCs, they ask, please suggest some teachers, those who are expert in ICT. Sometimes if I can some teachers in Nagaland, some teachers in New Delhi, Maharashtra, and Punjab. So I know a few people, those who are working in this field. Only one thing, I'm always sharing whatever I am doing, but nobody is in a position to create their own blog to share whatever they have. Sometimes they feel, hey, you are sharing everything, whatever you have, then what? Being a resource person, my duty to make my participants are self-reliant, self-dependent, not to depend on a resource person. So that is my agenda. Find identify major seminal works. Identify main methodologies and research techniques. While doing review of literature only, you can identify what is their objectives, what are their research questions and hypotheses, what techniques, sampling techniques they use, what type of research method they use, this type of things, very important. Identify main ideas. Conclusions and theories and establish similarities and differences. Provide a context for your own research. Show relationship between previous studies or theories. This is the purpose and components of ICT. You can use already, I saw these search, select, study, skillful, store, share, and smart. And qualitative research methods. This one already we started every Friday. Already we done phenomenology. Now we are going to do ethnography. Here, direct observation, focus group, open-ended survey, participant observation, literature review, some more. So here, qualitative research process. Identify the research topic or problem is the first step. Interest, known background, research questions, philosophy, foundation, study design, sampling, legal, ethical, and pilot study, data collection, data analysis, literature review. Even though they kept here, but for me, we are doing every step also literature review. Every step we are using. Findings and limitations and conclusions. Here already I mentioned this one also, qualitative and quantitative and mixed method. This one is ethnography. You can see. This is actually the search. What is a search? The acronym I given, specific content you need, excellent content, applicable content, reliable content, creative content, and helpful content. Whatever content is maybe not useful, no need. No, is a reliable. And whenever you are doing, these are very important, what to learn, where to learn, when to learn, whom to learn, why to learn, and how to learn. 5 W's 1 H. These are the 4 pillars of learning: learning to know, learning to do, learning to be, learning to live together. So whatever knowledge is the right place, where, right time, right purpose, right person, right thing, right knowledge. After reading, it is your duty to comprehend and be always positive. So thinking, we always think that there is only one or two types of thinking, convergent thinking or divergent thinking, but you can see abstract, analytical, artistic, and concrete, convergent, creative, critical, divergent, holistic, parallel, reflective, or logical, sequential, rational, and 360 degree thinking. These are the tips. Whenever you are using with the environment, when I was delivering lecture at the Environmental Science Department, Environmental Studies, NEHU, I did this one. Environment, if you use the keyword, I got the time 52 crores 80 lakhs content, but by using PDF, it almost filtered 50 crores of content, DOC, PPT, even within inverted quotation, and you can see star and question mark, asterisk, and or not, even combination of more than two functions. Here, see the same mode. I can take one example, environment and pollution, within inverted quotation, 55,400 only. Without quotation, you can see 1 crore 9 lakhs content. Where is 1 crore and what about 55,000? See how much we filtered. That's why these type of tips are very useful while doing your review of literature, because of these tips, you can filter, you can save your valuable time. So study, again, 5 W's and 1. Whenever you are doing, some researchers, they feel that I'm doing maximum things, but no, it is not up to the mark. Suppose to jump maybe 10 meters, how much strength you supposed to use, you know, the high jump, the athletes, you know, they need some strengths. How much strength to use? In the same way, it is your duty to use your maximum effort, everything, maximum time, maximum utilization. I like this one, research, review, react, research, reuse, everything, remix again and again. And what to study is a systematic research study itself, skimming and scanning language teachers you can do. While selecting it, suppose I selected this book, well, you can see the title of the book, author, publication, year of publication, publication place of the publication. That is skimming and see the content here and there. Scanning, reading 100% specific. So this is British Council, skimming language teachers, a reflective journey. Whenever you are using, always I'm using books, keeping and I'm noting down like this. It is we are calling a reflective journal. Skills, you need so many types of skills. Being a researcher, you need learning skills, even teaching skills, note-taking skills, and life skills, soft skills, communication skills. It is your duty to communicate. There are so many digital initiatives. There are 40 digital initiatives I provided here. You can go through it. And store whatever I have, what I did, I stored in my Google Drive and I shared through my blog, Hamsa Reddy. And it is your duty to become supreme master, approachable, reachable, and transferable teacher or researcher. This is again as such. So ICT toolkits, there are so many SPSS, a list of ICT tools in research, another 2 minutes only. I will ask some of participants to share your screen. So if you see, there are n number of ICT tools are there. Along with these reference tools, you can go through is a database, what type of here you can see. So research aptitude here, components of ICT, application of ICT in research here, generally application ICT for identify appropriate here, ICT in pre-data analysis, ICT in data analysis and post-data analysis. For literature search articles, you can see Shodhganga, Google Scholar, Microsoft Academic, Mendeley, SSR, and recently here, multidisciplinary online repository of scholarly research and related material. So recently I published an article here, again, already submitted 7 more articles to this SSRN and AIIMS, so that 7S model, I got the feedback from them. See, some other famous database, see how nicely, so many Joster, I have an article in under Joster and project here, so many content search, literature tracking, data collection, important data collection, see. N number of qualitative data, quantitative data. These are the tools you can use for data analysis, but we'll go tomorrow or day after tomorrow on these topics. Application of ICT in post data, reference and bibliography, already I mentioned EndNote, Jotero, Mendeley, so many things. See, like this, so there are n number of tools or ICT tools are available. Is your duty tips for writing a literature. This is actually a video. You can go through it. Do under here, e-library, 6 tips to write. Define already these things I mentioned in the literature review tips. Search question links, swimming pool approach, note taking techniques, recording background, data source, testing ideas, links to next section. And here, see, reference materials. We have Atlas, you already know, Almanac, and the dictionary, encyclopedia, manual, and thesaurus. So these are, you can see, for what purpose? A book published every year that includes information and interesting facts about the special subjects such as sports or the weather. These are manuals here, reference books that contains words and their synonyms. When it is online also, it is available. So this is the best way for those who don't have internet. What you can do, always go to reference menu of Word and you can go to select APA 6th edition right now is available under. So you can select whatever you want, Chicago, here see so many review types. This is a number of tools, bibliography and citation reference tools, and these are the. So if you have any queries, I'm ready to answer. At least we can enroll that of MOOC courses before anyone. If you have, and now I'm allowing the participants to interact. If you have any queries, I'm ready to answer before going for hands-on activities. We have another, we'll take 9:10 up to 9:10 because we started 10 minutes. So tomorrow onwards, I will start, even though that participants are requesting, but it is not good. We already mentioned that time. It is better to go for already exactly I received message from Subramanian sir. Any other? Dr. Raja Ghosh, because of you, I minimized my presentation style slowness and compared with a little bit fastly in general.
Thank you, sir.
Most welcome, sir.
Actually, what happened today, yesterday I joined from my cell phone. But today I joined from my laptop. I joined early, but I think I have to, after completion of everything, I have to click on the join. But I did not click. Probably for that reason. And then I tried from cell phone also like that. So confusion arise. That is why I sent on message to you also.
Welcome, sir. Sonali Jaiswal, you are asking, again, show us a type of review. Simply, I can post you the link. You can keep that link instead of taking the screenshot. I can show you. You can take screenshot also, no problem. You need this one? Which one, Sonali?
Sir,
actually, this one.
Okay, sir, post the link. I can see.
Yeah. So I'm posting. Actually, I didn't share. Okay. You are not seeing my screen. Actually, I forgot to share. Okay. Now I'm sharing again. So this is actually the 14 review types. I'm posting two citations and review types both. You can keep this link, you will get.
Okay, sir.
For the benefit of our participants, everything I kept in my blog. So these two blog you can keep. Right, any other? Okay, we can take another 10 minutes at least. Anyone yesterday joined the course, MOOC courses? Okay, I think I can ask Aparajita Jaws. I think who is joined through laptop, those who have good internet. Maximum. Tanveer Alam. Anyone here? Tanveer Alam ji? Is it possible to share your otherwise Susma Ja? Is it possible to share your screen? Susma Ja? Are you there? Okay, then it is better I can take by myself. I will take only 5 minutes then. So this is actually the MOOC course, what I supposed to show you. Future long. This one self-directed, please go through by yourself. But one course is not available already. I told it is a wish list, so I can show that one to all of you. I think this course is not available right now. No? How to are discovering your PhD potential. I think how to write is not. So, right, this is not available right now, Oslo University. So this week one, welcome. Just I can show you because you can go through the YouTube videos. It is, everything is telecasted. While going through your video, you can. So here, welcome to the course in general. These first three steps is common in the any MOOC courses for Future Law, yeah, Deakin University, Oslo, Griffith University. These universities are doing extraordinary work on research. So this is introduction of the course. Actually, the third step onwards, it will start. Right. Structure and writing style in PhD proposal. It is your duty. In this course, we will work together on the main sections of PhD proposal. To assist you in the process, we have prepared a template. I can share this template with all of you. We suggest this one way structure for PhD proposal. So this is actually the we will organize the activities in course with the following elements: research statement, literature review, design and method. By seeing this structure only, I framed our program, problem and research problem, literature review and data design and research design and methods. And plan and define steps you can do, ensure the proposed study follows conventions regarding reliability, validity, and ethical conduct. Here, project organization, advice, and contingency plans and research group. So this 4 weeks, how nicely they prepared this one. So template, we can suggest what type of template they're giving. This is luckily available to download from the YouTube. You can't see. Sonali, are you able to see? Someone is posting, we can't see like that. It is maybe because of their network issue.
Yes, sir. Sir, I'm seeing.
Okay. Pusparke Sutradas, it is see. Whenever you have always better, you can go through YouTube. You can see if it is not visible for you. Because of your network, it is not visible. You can't feel that. Don't feel that it is not visible for all. Right. So I'm posting this template with all of you through chat box. You can download and keep. Sometimes it is better. What I did, I spent almost 8,000 rupees for printing and these things. Always better something. What should I do? Someone is posting. What? Susmaja. No, you are responding to lately, Susmaji. Right. Leave it. Title one line, short, here, sweet, and CSC, how nicely they are mentioning. Relevance and significance of the proposed project, approximately one page. And background and status of knowledge, approximately 3 pages. So your proposal must be, and objective, design and method, three pages. And project organized, approximately 2 to 3 pages. And references. So all together, if you count 4 plus 3, 7, 7 plus 3, 10, almost 10 pages or up to 12 pages. So this is a brief. Sometimes we are taking, but here not exceed 10 pages. They mentioned very nicely. This is suggested template to help PhD research proposal here. The proposal should normally not exceed 10 pages. Pages are indicative and it is up to you to decide how to use space for the different sections of research proposal. Better, this is very important. Even I think tomorrow, instead of the PowerPoint presentation, I can go through the MOOC course itself. That is good for all of you because this content is not available for you. And before concluding, I can show you one of my research scholars' latest research proposals she shared with me. And I can show you. Just only takes 2 minutes, then we can go for a national anthem and the feedback I can show you. So this is a recently research proposal. So her research topic is like this, a PhD research proposal, digital empowerment, learning styles and academic achievement of student teachers in Arunachal Pradesh. So here, the content page is divided like this: introduction, review of literature, second one, research gap, need and justification of the study, statement of the problem, operational definition of the key terms used, objectives of the study, hypothesis of the study. Actually put research questions, but a tip of DRC suggested to remove, so the research scholars removed. Delimitations of the study and methodology. Within methodology of the study, population, sample, variables of the study, tools for data collection, within sample, sampling techniques also, data collection, research method, analysis of the data, flow chart. I can show you this flow chart is, but see here, we used almost 23 pages. We because they're asking so many things, so we don't have freedom to delimit by ourselves because it is committee. So introduction here also we use it more, but in future we can minimize almost 1.5 pages, but it is not good. According to the reviews, they say it is better to 2 para, less than 1 page, concept of digital empowerment. Here you can see how the reviews see done and concept of, actually we are showing the Google Doc, that's why the alignment may be different, but in original it is systematic. So this one, right, concept of, so see given based on concept and digital empowerment interrelated of the three concepts. Literature review here, studies related. What's he done? You can see maybe a done all old to newest 2018-19. Otherwise, theme-based, used her own methods he mentioned, and the studies related to learning style. Then what's he done? Research gaps. They identified the research gap and the need and justification of the study, statement of the problem, operation definition of the key terms used, and the objectives of the study, hypothesis, then delimitations of the study, methodology, under she provided the list of colleges and the population, variables, dependent and independent variables, and data collection. This is the flowchart. See how nicely she provided here. Phase one, identification of a research problem, first step. You can see the last writing of thesis is the last step. Phase one, phase two, phase three, phase four. So by seeing this single flowchart, you can identify how she is going to do. Identification of research gaps, and here development of the research tools. She is going to construct her own tools. She is not able to adapt any tool. All the tools she will construct, and at the selection of sample, final study, and here scoring, coding, analysis of data, preparation of table, charts and figures, and interpretation of data, then review and connection, whole finals, submission of the thesis. See, within one page, he can give A to Z. So this type of thing is very important in the research proposal, but it is up to you. Some of teachers, they said no need to give this proposal flow chart, but I said, we create research itself is a creative. It is better to do like that. So, right. So I can share this proposal also with all of you. That is nothing secret. Anyone, if you have any query? Sonali?
Sir?
Do you have any query?
Sir, you have seen in proposal the data collection and the population and samples. That, is it possible that how much sample we have mentioned, we got the data from them?
Yeah, actually what you can do, in general, if a population, based on your population size, you can decide, some researcher, they say 30% or 50%. So here what we did, almost we taken the 50% of the sample, because the 1,800 population, so 900 sample we collected. This is possible. Even we have, I can show you the upcoming days, sample fix one tool, online tool is there. If you give your population and degrees of freedom, everything automatically significant, whether 0.01 level or 0.05 level, automatically it can show you how much sample you can take.
Okay, sir.
So it is better if you take more sample and your result is maybe a very good, and you can generalize. This is in general, right? For qualitative research, you can't take more, even sometimes 2% or 5% of the population, because here purpose is not to create a generalize, not to generalize the result. It is better to create a theme. So that's why, based on your research, your population and sample also will change.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
And another thing, what Subramani, sir?
There is only random sampling, yes, sir?
No, not random, only sir. Random. It is up to you, based on your research objectives. Yes, sir. the purpose. You can suppose a random when you take in general, when you are going to generalize your result, you can take the random. Otherwise, you can purpose sampling or convenience sampling, non-probability sampling. But in never non-probability sampling, you cannot generalize the data, and you can maybe as a parametric and non-parametric test also you can based on your data. So the purpose, that's why what purpose you are doing research, that is important. Whenever you are doing anything, why, question yourself whether to generalize the result or to create a concept or to create a theory. For creating a theory, you can select the convenient sampling only. You can't suppose ambassador car, so all are not using, so some are using the other type of car. Here you can see those who are using only ambassador car is a convenient purpose.
Thank you, sir.
Welcome. Yeah, Raja Ghosh sir, you have any query? You raised your hand.
Yes, sir. I think probably you suggest us to share our screen, no, sir?
By yeah.
May I share, sir, now?
Now, tomorrow be ready. Today our program over. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Now, thank you. I am going to share your feedback form after national anthem. 1 minute, you will get your certificate immediately. Thank you very much for your...
जन गण मन अधिनायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता पंजाब सिंध गुजरात मराठा द्राविड उत्कल बंगा विंध्य हिमाचल यमुना गंगा उच्चल जलधि तरंगा तव शुभ नामे जागे तव शुभ आशीष मांगे गाहे तव जय गाथा जन गण मंगल दायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे जय हे
Jai Hind. Thank you and see you tomorrow at 7:30 exactly. I can start. Now I'm sharing the feedback link with all of you. Please fill. After checking your certificate only, you can leave. Because sometimes what is happening, some of participants, they submitted, but they entered their email ID wrongly. So they are not in a position to get, please. In that cases, it is better always. Just only 1 minute. And Vidya Sagar sir, I think you are there and I shared the feedback form yesterday for you because we were network issue, please.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Good. Yeah.
Welcome. Sometimes whenever I say something no, that is to change your behavior and expect something from you. Don't take anything negatively. Feedback form of yes. Please submit.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah, please.
Sir, I think probably that due to that reason, I may miss 5 to 10 minutes. So I think I will get in the YouTube streaming. No, sir.
No. You will get your class. You are telling about the class. You will get. Yes,
sir.
Please. Now I am sharing the YouTube link here already. It is available my flyer also, but
okay,
if you
sir.
Want, I can share here also. You can go through it.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Better, you can, if you want, you can subscribe our channel. You will get automatically to your mail. That is good.
Sure, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Okay.